Yeah! Can you ask why is America number one? I'm trying to think.
That's a good fucking question, ain't it? Truly, I'm not being a smartass. It's a good fucking question because you got a coward for a fucking chicken shit president. He should have been in the goddamn Vietnam War and he wasn't because his daddy kept him in a National Guard reserve unit so fucking far back in the boonies they couldn't find him.
Okay, yeah.
So he's a chicken shit fucking coward to all of us guys that served over there.
Really?
I'd like to meet him. I really would. Not to shake his hand, but to tell the son of a bitch, hey, don't worry about it, motherfucker.
Yeah.
I did 3 tours, 18 months each over there.
Yeah.
You can have one of mine.
Okay, well.
That's all I want to say to him.
Really, yeah. Do you think majority of people in service think that?
Most of us guys that served in Korea and served in Vietnam right now, we're doing the best we can to get these guys pulled back to the Middle East right now because all they got going is another Vietnam.
Oh, okay.
And we're raising 7 kinds of hell, and it's putting a lot of hot pressure on the old man up the White House there.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
So why are we number one? As far as I'm concerned, we're really not.
Really?
Yeah.
All right.
Take a look around. Take a look at China.
Yeah.
Those people, man, they got more fucking people we'd have to bomb for 16 fucking years. 16 fucking years to kill all those people.
Yeah.
So how the fuck can we say we're number one? We're giving them all of our technology and giving it to them.
Yeah.
Number one? I don't think so.
Right. Well, okay. Do you think we're number one at anything?
Yeah, fucking the public.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Fucking their own people. That's what they're really good at. 10 years ago, a dumb boy wife, there's going to be 2 classes of people. You're either going to be rich or you're going to be poor. There will be no middle class, and you're on your way right now, real quick.
This is a white man's country. You people don't belong here. Want to talk about race mixing, destruction of culture, destruction of all races involved. Race mixing is not only destruction of the white race, it's destruction of every single race involved in this planet.
This invasion is not just wrong because it is illegal. This invasion is not wrong just because these invaders don't have the right kind of papers in their wallets, or because they speak another language, which, after all, is just the language of the white European explorers and pioneers that was imposed upon them hundreds of years ago. This invasion is wrong because these people are profoundly different from us in every way. They are profoundly different from us genetically, in a way that British or Frenchmen or Russians are not very different from us, being as we are, descended from the adventurous among all the strains of European men.
Let me tell you what's going to take guts is to sit here and continue to be passive about this nonsense, and then face the world as these people like the president administration, Theodore Knox, and all these other bums that are seem to be running this country, when they get done with their little orchestration, the job, whatever it is their job is, and I think it's to keep that border open, however we describe it, when they get done with it, organizing the world that you know around you, maybe the right word is disorganized. Maybe we're talking about entropy here, creating a state of nature around us. When they get done with that, that's when you're going to need guts, let me tell you. That's when you're going to need guts. Because you cannot have a vacuum like you have in this country. You cannot have the people who founded this country, largely of European descent, act like such a bunch of wimps and not provoke an aggressive reaction. Can you not sense the change in temperament among our new neighbors, formerly neighbors to the south? And I'm going to be kind of cautious here because, again, I know so many Mexican people, and I know so many of them are just so terribly earnest in their nature. But, you know, it doesn't matter. Their temperament, their civility, their goodness, that's not what matters.
Choke on mother's meat.